It's your boy Stylish, rocking the new hairstyle today, feeling inspired, back at it again with a new Learn with Stylish video for you guys. This one's gonna be covering the Oriana matchup, a lot of tips and tricks to actually win that lane almost every time. Also, I'm gonna do a couple of announcements on this intro. First one is that there's gonna be a second video coming out tonight with a massive giveaway that we're doing to thank you guys for all the love that we've been given. Also, I'm working on a new series that is gonna teach you guys everything that I know about Zed. It's kind of like a Zed school series where you guys are basically gonna go from nothing to knowing everything about Zed, just like me. And obviously I'm still working on the drama live video, so a lot of content is coming out, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video and stay blessed.
Cut the last breath from them.
All right, guys, so this one we're gonna be covering the Oriana versus Zed matchup. The subs make it a little hard, but this one we're gonna be covering the Oriana versus Zed matchup. I'm still running my precision runes. First thing you do in this lane, obviously, is freeze it into you, as usual. The point of the lane is to get to level four, with two bots, right? You don't want to play over aggressive early on. You just want to try to secure the CS you can without getting harassed. See how I missed one CS? Because she had a good Q positioning. So this lane is going to be about missing a lot and a lot and a lot of CS, just to make sure that when you hit level 4, you're able to still have two pots, just like her. And at level 4, you can actually trade as hard as her. So if you outplay her abilities, then you can start winning, right? So it's just going to be some safe-ass laning phase. Can't last hit that. I'm going to take too much damage. QW basic. Not worth it. You're going to fall behind in CS for sure, but the point is, if you do win the lane, I'm gonna bait the Q. Here we go. Always walk to like low minion HP that are last hittable with the basic, pretending that you're gonna last hit them, but you just wanna bait the ability. No ability, no pressure. Q cooldown is up. Should have backed off a little bit more. It's just a lot of patience. We are level 3, we can get a trade. I'm gonna save that W for when she comes in their tower, because that W will help me be able to trade if she tries to harass me too hard in the tower. I could actually use it right now. Alright, got electrocute proc, evened out the trade. I'm still at 3 pots, and it's level 3, which means that I'm hitting my level 4 with 4 pots already, right? With 2 pots, what am I saying? So we're doing really good, pretty much. Despite having health for CS. The worst part in this is that she has only one pot, so that's even greater. Okay, now I have vision. Topside, I want to play aggressive now that we're level 4, so I'm gonna throw one here. Oh, really?
They got a little too high.
Oh, really?
Buds are green with a lovely hue. Please smoke on stream. Oh wait, I think I saw your cue.
What are you saying, dog? I'll go for a trade here. She used her cue, so I could all in and get one more basic. But I have to back off because extended trade I lose. She's looking to shove the wave because she has no pots, right? If a mid laner does that, that means he's gonna try to back. It's fine by me, because like this wave is small, so I can clear really fast, get to push the next one. And then because I do that, I'm gonna have CS and XP lead, or at least XP lead. And you see the CS you've been missing early game? Well, that's when you get it back, pretty much, right here. You get that CS lead back. Alright, hard shoving. Bomb. And we're outie. This way, I'm 34, she's 34, I'm 29, even though I missed like 10, 15 CS to make sure that I wouldn't lose the lane. I'm thinking about doing a different build here. Not sure if it's gonna work, but I'm in the rush of Stormraiser here. She didn't build any armor, so a Dirk could have actually been better, but it's okay. Now the lane is even, except that you don't go through the level 1 to 3 where your champion does absolutely nothing, right? So they start straight up with an aggressive lane if you can outplay. So what you gotta do is obviously with vision first. I don't want to go through because I'm gonna get poked, right? But now I can get the ward. This way I can play aggressive. She has no vision topside, so And she's trying to hard shove, so I can actually... Where is my electrocute? My Eve is trolling so hard. If she just tanked tower while I was going, like, while I pinged that, she would have been able to... I would have been able to R back without dying. Alright, whatever. It's okay. We didn't kill, we didn't get a kill assist, but... Lane is freezing into me, so it's a bit of a win for me. I kind of want to buy a longsword, because, I mean... That's the thing with rushing Stormraiser, is the BF costs so much, but... I'll just ask Eve to gank again now that we burn flash. Try to gank her again. No sounds. She has her flash, so they should net into a free kill. I'm gonna need help to keep laning, because I can't spend that gold, right? Up until I buy the BF, I'll probably just need help or I'll play passive. That Ori is prioritizing shoving a lot. She doesn't really care about laning, I don't think. Then again, she doesn't have sums to care about laning. How did I lose as much HP as her when I only got hit by E? Oh my god. Nice. Okay, that's really good, dude. Exactly how he was supposed to go. No pressure. I'll ask her to help me shove this so that the Graze doesn't zone my ass. And I feel like that Graves gonna like freeze that wave, sadly. Yeah. Motherfucker, dude. I can't back because he's doing that. But he's gonna die if she hits him. Alright, fuck you, dude. I'm gonna trade one for one. No! I didn't trade one for one. Oh, I'm so sad. I'm actually sad. Damn. I'm so sad. If I got the kill, I wanted to trade one for one. Because I get my BF, right? But I didn't get shit.
Fish, take my sub now. Keep it up. Wish me luck. I have an exam TM on R.
So it's okay, whatever. It was a bit of a mistake. The Grace tried to freeze. I have to stay to make sure I don't lose an XP. Greeted a little bit, mistakes were made, it's all good. I'm gonna lane up until I can just back and buy BF, then I'll do it and I'll play aggressive again. Cause she has very, like, she has no armor. I don't know if she's building. Ludens, I guess? She's in this bush, has enough for a last chapter, I believe, so she's just gonna back. That's perfect for me, because that means I can just like shove this and get out of this lane, get my BF. 10 out of 10. This is one of these games where, like, it wouldn't be a bad idea to roam, right? But I haven't looked at sides at all, because it's just so aggressive mid lane that you just play mid lane this game, right? But like, if Orianna stops playing the same way, then I'll probably camp the fuck out of Karthus, because it is Karthus mid, I mean top. Your goal is just to get snowballed and get ready for mid game. Nothing else matters. I think the Graze. See, there's nothing in my jungle, right? So I'm assuming he's gonna ward either this or that, and then he's gonna path through the Krugs. That way I know he's gonna gank bottom. I don't need to tell my bottom because they're backing. But it's always good to look at where their junglers go in, what he could be doing, and determine where he's gonna be. Oh, this is actually free. This is actually free. I chatted Jabay in case that kill, but she waited to rescue. She outcased me. We can dive Graves. I'm gonna go like the bottom way. I'm gonna go this way, stay hidden, because I want her to not be seen. I'll tank tower, then reset it with R. I don't need to reset it, actually. Damn, me and this Eve are playing like gods together. This is great. Is that my Stormraiser? Okay. Get the next wave. And then just recall then. Perfect. You see, this way now I can actually start playing side. Because now, I don't even really need Eve anymore. and at the same time, Oriana cannot play the same way because I'm that much stronger than her. So now we're gonna do a lot more roaming. Same logic applies. Roaming calls for a red trinket, a dusk blade, and boost level 2. So you already know what I'm gonna be building. I'm not gonna be building dusk because I went storm, but you know, dusk is a good roaming item. Yomo's is a better roaming item for the movement speed. Boost level 2 helps you roam faster, obviously, and then you got red trinket for the wards. So those are, since I'm not gonna go dusk or Yomo's, the next one is gonna be boost level 2. I got you, dude. I'll R the plant.
What?
Dude. Holy shit, I'm trolling. I was supposed to R the plant. So that this doesn't happen, you know? I don't know if you feel me. Okay, well, let's just pretend that I felt bad for the Ori. Yes, yes. How's bot lane going? But it's a hard lane to gank because my bot lane offers absolutely no CC. Absolutely no CC. And the biggest problem comes from the fact that their bot lane has a bunch of CC and blood is hard to kill. So like roaming there is a little bit awkward. I can kill that guy too. I don't think he has exhaust or ulti. Kind of forgot what he used in that fight. Alright, let's hard shot this. And then we'll decide what to do. Don't do it, Ori. You don't want to do that. If she Qs, she's dead. Alright, she's dead. What I tell you? Dodge that. The Karthus R won't kill me. Oh, he was stopped. Poppy? I think I would have lived because I dodged the Graves R. But if I didn't dodge it, that Poppy would have saved my ass so hard. Rule of thumb against Oriana. This is one of the most important things you need to know about this matchup is the way you can deny an Oriana controlling her ball while you're on top of her. And what I mean by that is, let's say she Qs, right? During the last trade where I ulted her, she Q'd me and I dodged it, right? Then she E'd the ball. The moment where she uses her E, that ECD is not like the Q cooldown, right? It's pretty high. So the moment where she uses it, she cannot get the ball back anymore, right? So then if you back off and she tries to Q you for more trade, if you press R, there's absolutely no way she can move the ball for the next 3 seconds, which means free kill. So always try to bait the E and then stay kind of close, but not too close. And if she does Q you, you R, she's dead. Or she flashes out, but she just cannot do damage to you. Remember, one trick against Oriana in the 1v1. I'm gonna hard shot this and see what's up. At this point, I bought back, so that's not even an option. Top lane is free because it's Karthus. Or he's inting. Actually, I'm just gonna get mid lane. This will open the map and open the gates. That way, I can deep ward this and we can have just more control. I'll gank top later. Holy shit. I do no damage to this tower though. Legit. I'm actually not be able to get that tower since he's here. But if he does deny me the tower on the next push, I'll be waiting for him on the red side jungle. He came from the bot side jungle, which means he has no camps to do anymore here. Which means that right after finishing that, he either recalls or walks through this jungle. I assume he's gonna check this bush because we've been playing really ham. So I'm gonna sit here instead. Seems like he's recalling. He would have came. Okay, he is recalling. I could wait for, yeah. This is a good play too, and then we end up getting mid tower. A little bit delayed, but I feel bad. Me and this Eve are just smurfing all over them. We're gonna win this game by together. We don't need no one else. It's crazy. I'm gonna follow up on the play. I go right away behind the tower because that's where they're gonna go. Damn. I feel like I'm so slow with that Yomu's when I roam. Look at that shit. I'll go for the blood. The Graze is probably dead already. Wow, I thought he had W. That's why I played it slower. But he didn't. This is gonna be fun part 4. Where Oriana will never expect this gank, but it's happening anyways. Like, she probably thinks we backed or something. I'm surprised she's not in lane already, though. Maybe he won't go for the play. You wanna go right now? I don't have W, though. This is disgusting, dude. This feels bad. Oh my god. I mean, good synergy between mid lane jungle is what it gives you. That guy has no armor, so if he face check me, I can murder his ass. I don't have ult though, but it's so risky. I can't one shot him. Arthas? Alright, never mind. I'm the path bottom lane. I'm out. I'm gonna go get the bot. Let my Kai'Sa stay a bit. Oh, the fuck? I actually don't have that yet. I would have did the Wraith camp if I knew. This Phage and Kindle Jam gives you absolutely nothing but like 300 HP. Like, you don't have more damage, which means that I've been spending 2800 gold in towards no damage at all. I gotta finish this item ASAP. Game plan is easy now. All I'm gonna do is always go from base to either bot or top. Push the wave. This'll get pressure in that lane, and then I'll decide what to do. Usually you have three options. One is to stay in one bush and make a catch on whoever comes to farm that wave. So you would just like retrinket your way in the bush, wait for someone. There's the one where you just go for the tower. That's usually what you do if there's no one defending, or like it's a better game to split push. And the last option is to push the wave, use your retrinket and rotate behind them through the jungle and get a flank team fight. Those are the options. I don't gotta go bot. It's already pushed, so I'm just gonna go like... Actually, I'm still gonna go bot because like... They don't need help. Their team is making the play top lane, which is wrong play to do. So my team is gonna get bot for sure. I'm just gonna go get damage in the bot tower. It's kind of greedy though what they're doing. It's gonna be 3v4 in a sec. Am I necessarily spamming tap to check scoreboard? Yeah, scoreboard, items. Sometimes I just do it as a nervous like... Just to tap something, you know what I mean? Like, LS taps his escape thing. I like to tap something sometimes. I like to tap my board. Oh my god, dude.
13 months, XD. I'm starting to hate League of all the toxic people, so gonna take a break, smiley face.
Man, I'm canceling so many of my basic attacks. It is my first game of the day, though, if y'all wondering. At the end of the day, like, it's 27. The game is pretty over, I'd say. But, like, I'm still gonna upload this because I believe the early game explanation and the matchup explanation were perfect. And if you can follow that, you'll always come out at least even, if not on top. You just gotta understand the reason why it's so important to miss all the CS on Zed early game. Just because you have to. I'm dying. Their blue is coming up. I'll just do that. Thinking about doing the Hex Shrinker now. This build has very little damage for now, because, I mean, I'm not spiking yet, and it has absolutely no lethality. If I was building lethality, I'd be doing more damage to these champs. Only because they have no armor, right? This build would be better against them if they had armor. I'm gonna die if I try this. He's gonna pull and fuck me up. This is such a bad idea. Why am I so greedy as a player? guys know. Never mind. I had one chance of winning only, and it was if he misses his first E. Lucky enough, he pressed it too early. Because if he E's Q's, then waits a little bit, pulls and E's again, I'm dead. But hey, we're Gucci. Alright, so I'm thinking about doing Hex Shrinker, but I don't know, dude. At this point, their APs are kind of weak to me. I mean, 1-8-1. I should still do it, though. And again, I could get Lethality and just kill them. Yeah. I'm gonna prioritize damage. Whatever. I'll sell this and buy a bit of MR that's gonna go into Hex Shrinker later. Bye-bye! Welcome to Balanced. And a half. How did they not FF this game yet? They didn't just do better and then they'll FF it. Yeah, sadly I'm not able to give you guys more details about the mid-late game and how to play it in this Learn to Stylish video. So it might actually just speed up this part of the game. Because there's nothing happening and we're just hard winning, right? But I believe the early game was really useful. Yeah, they FF'd. GG's, man. Well, that'll be it for this one.